have a strange feeling about it.
Ten, nine, eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, one, zero.
Wednesday night, and you know what that means. Amateur radio from radios. Amateur. Good evening, Durham on air. Welcome back, dear friends, to Chris Pollard Live, which is tonight being presented as the headline act at this year's County Durham Yeast Festival. The only festival in the UK that shines a well-deserved light on the production of yeast. From tubs of Marmite to a personal infection, County Durham Yeast Fest has your selection. This show is sponsored here tonight by Scary Bob's Really, Really Scary Cabbages. Don't fork out money on an expensive pumpkin this year. Come to Scary Bob's Spooky Allotment, where due to a mix-up in seed delivery, I am now the proud owner of 300 terrifying Halloween cabbages, just in time to decorate before they go mouldy. Five for a quid, you're going to need a few if you're putting lit candles inside, and they stink. In a week where Trevor McDonald was announced as the all-seeing games master in the revival of the hit game show, following a thrashing 3-0 victory against Eamon Holmes on FIFA 22 in the final. And also in the week where more people than ever are deciding to keep a slice of ham in their wallets for their own personal well-being. Why? Let's find out why on tonight's programme.
On tonight's programme.
Because on tonight's programme, as late as it is, we will be welcoming to the couch one-third of boy band JLS. We are yet to confirm which of the letters it will be, but I've got my sneaking suspicions. And if I'm right, I bet there'll be L on. But that's all to come later. On tonight's programme, 27 minutes late, on Durham on Air. Durham on Air. Welcome back to Chris Pollard Live. Before the break, you heard the Eagles of Death Metal with Oh Girl, a super group that is indeed a group that is super. At the start of the late show, you heard Momentary Bliss by Gorillaz featuring Slow Tie and Slaves. And after the ad break there, you've just heard Over the Edge by Wipers from the album Over the Edge from 1983. Can you believe it, people? I can. It sounded like it, didn't it? If you want to get in touch with tonight's programme and express your views, opinions and news, please do so by texting studio plus your message to 8802. You can email studio at durhamonair.com or you can tweet at durhamonair. Where tonight I am asking you the big question. Big question. Still haven't got a jingle for that. Your big question tonight, listeners, why won't Britain stop pumping out cream cheese? Our best comment or message will win an opportunity to have a personal tour around a factory full of sexual pistachio shells. Still to come on tonight's Chris Pollard Live, we take another trip down to Clewsbury Common, my all-new radio micro soap, and we'll be traversing the plains of Community Corkboard and finishing tonight's programme with the very touching tribute I made to all the flies that we lost this year. But that's all to come much, much later on Chris Pollard Live. Right now, it's time for your top five. This week, it's your top five alternative Halloween costumes. Coming in at number five, a big scary crab. Number four, John Turode. Number three, an insurance salesman with the legs of a St. Bernard. Number two, a broken promise. And your number one, corned beef hash. Chris Pollard live on Durham on air. Welcome back to Chris Pollard Live. It's Wednesday night, my dudes, and we are chortling through this programme. Chortling? Is that a word? It's a word, surely. You've just heard Wings of a Dove by Madness. I thought it'd be a nice pick-up from the pace of the last song, The Mystery Lights, with Flowers in My Hair, Demons in My Head. Lovely tune, love it, if somewhat dreary. That's from the self-titled Mystery Lights 2016 album. I hope you're doing all right, wherever you're listening to tonight's Chris Pollard Live. Just checking the emails. Not a sausage. It is Halloween in a few days, so let's consider this the Halloween special. And I'm sure you'll have felt it as well. There is just an invariable wave of terror and eeriness doth betrove our once resilient nation. Our kids are all now, you know, preparing their outfits. My two young'uns, Destiny and Chimbo, they're both going as two cute little scabs, unable to afford to continue striking, shamefully returning to those they swore to never again bow to. I'm going dressed as Thatcher, and I am ready for what I have coming to me. She deserves it. I don't mind taking some collateral. But let's take a look back now at my top 10 favourite, spooky favourite Halloween classic songs, ready to recharge your playlists for any spooky parties you might be having. Unless you are living on your own, I suppose the idea of someone listening to novelty Halloween music on their own could be indeed the scariest thing of all. This is my personal list, you know, so don't take this as objective. If there's something I've missed as well, keep it to yourself. But let's make this very quick, and then we'll get on with some more music for you. At number 10, my 10th favourite Halloween sort of novelty song was the Couplands Quartet, their 1992 sort of smasher, Cake with Scary Icing On, which was well known up and down nightclubs for the catchy hook. You still haven't cleaned those towels. You still haven't cleaned those towels. Number 9 was the first and only novelty song made by U2. Unless you count everything they've released in the 21st century. But nothing puts a chill up my spine at this time of year in a Celtic rock fashion more than their 1996 hit Pubes in the Soup again. In at number 8, one of the best acoustic Halloween melodies of all time, the incomparable John Clagg and How to Load a Dishwasher Properly. Number 7 is Paul McCartney's lesser known take on the monster mash, The Ghastly Gravy. And if you play both at the same time, that sounds terrible. Number 6, no introduction needed, it's Clickety Fingers with Clickety Fingers off their debut, Clickety Fingers. Number 5 is the iconic theme song from one of 1979's most unforgettable cinematic horror experiences. Composed by legend of film Stanley Suitcase, it is, of course, the main title theme from Attack of the Athlete's Foot. In at number 4 is the cast of Emmerdale Farm with their imaginative tribute cover of Slipknot's Pulse of the Maggots, featuring that one that lives on the farm shouting really loud. Top 3 time, and let's get this over and done with quickly, because it's no coincidence all 3 here are by the same artist. Because yes, they are Halloween themed, but they would be my top 3 non-Halloween things. That wouldn't be eligible. They would be my top 3 songs ever. It's my favourite artist of all time, jazz hypnotist Tubes Cuboid, and his Trilogy of Terror, which I've ranked here from worst to best, 3-1. I've got Night of the Living Apricots, Death by Shoehorn, and Suspended by the Testicles above Stoke-upon-Trent. Here's something that's not so spooky from you, from a band called Baked Beans. Here's Slow. I'll see you in a few. Mo? Welcome back to Chris Pollard Live. There was Mystic Braves with Mystic Braves with Bright Blue Day Haze. They've done that on purpose, haven't they? Here's Mystic Braves with Bright Blue Day Haze. There you go. Damaged Bug came before that with Cough Pills. Love that. From 2015's Cold Hot Plums. Love that too. Yes, it is 10:15, which means that we've got to fire into some adverts very soon. But not before our previously advertised two postings we've got here this week on your community cork board.
The County Durham Community Cork Board.
Hello there. I didn't go anywhere. Welcome to the County Durham Community Cork Board, the one-stop shop for all those public postings, notices and services available in your area, posted by you, for you, and read out by me. Our first of two postings today, the owner of the Ford Garage on Breckton Road has written in, asking me to let you all know that he will no longer tolerate random acts of kindness on his forecourt. Not only has he had to witness three people get out and help with an elderly motorist who had broken down, he yesterday witnessed a man open the door for someone in a wheelchair. Can you all please just pack it in, he writes. No one's been nice to me since Diane left. Our second posting on the community court board was sent to us from Big Dave Footlocker. If you're running low on sweets to provide your weird neighbour's children this Halloween, give me a call for Big Dave's egregious scooping early birds. My children are under strict instructions to go trick-or-treating this year at 6:15 a.m. and they'll both be carrying two homemade sweetie scoops that I developed based on the newest JCB Combi PXM214 model. They will knock on every single door from the house next to Maplin's all the way to the house on the other side of Dr. Dungaree's Chicken Shack for the Deaf. This is an estimated shift of 5 hours, 3,000 houses, and has an expected payload of 52.7 kg of treats. They can be bagged up and sent to your door at any point, anywhere in County Durham, in Halloween, to any door, as long as it's attached to a house. Call before 11 p.m. because the only people out trick-or-treating at that time are sex offenders. Here's Parquet Courts with Almost Had to Start a Fight. I'll see you after the ad break, here on Chris Pollard Live. Welcome back to Chris Pollard Live. You have just heard the fantastic Squid with GSK from their fantastic album that came out this year, Bright Green Fields. Honestly, one of the best albums you'll hear all this year. Along with, if we've got any hip hop heads out there, I don't play hip hop on this show, it doesn't mean I don't listen to it. Little Sims, that's all I'm going to say. If you know what I'm talking about, you know what I'm talking about. If you don't, check out Little Sims' new album. Sometimes I am introvert. Type in Little Sims introvert into Google. Feast your ears on some of that. Still to come on tonight's programme. Tonight's programme, Possessive. Why, I still think it's okay. We've received a few messages here on Chris Pollard Live so far tonight. Let's hold on while they load. Our first one, Karen Turkey has texted in to say, I've got a pocket full of parsley. Catch me if you're sarcastic enough. Next up, John and Winnie, 32 and 32 respectively, are listening to tonight's Chris Pollard Live while wearing this season's new Catheter Bamboo designer off-the-shoulder short hemline dress. John in peach with blue accent and Winnie in peach with blue accent respectively. Available now for £13 each or 15 for two on the market, on the stall, next to the bloke who sells poppers and BB guns, which coincidentally also pop. Our final text, Georgie is listening with all the family at the wake of my Uncle Alan. We're very relieved as he's been asleep all week and the music you played made him jolt upright and be sick on my sister's Crocs. That's all the text we've got. If you want to add to that, please text studio and your message to 8802. But for now, it's King Khan and the Shrines with Land of the Freak. You're listening to Durham on Air. It's Wednesday night, baby. Big old coffin fit there. Hello, welcome, yes, and back there to Chris Pollard Live. It's Wednesday night, and we are rapidly approaching the end of tonight's programme. But still to come here on Durham On Air tonight, the fun is not over. Steady. Because at 11 p.m. we have the fantastic Fox with the Punk Corner. I love that show. If you're liking some of the more aggressive cuts featured on tonight's programme, make sure you stick around for that power hour to see you through into midnight. And if you would like to get in touch with tonight's programme in the last half hour, now would be the best time to do so, as I prepare myself for tonight's grand finale, in which I, Chris Pollard, will attempt to be the first man on earth to wear a hand-me-down apron the wrong way round while arranging assorted flavours of crisps with my toes. We have asked for a Guinness representative to be present, but the response I received was somewhat on the abusive side. Regardless, I have my elderly neighbour Jorge here, who is currently in the kitchen looking at biscuits. My style of music is a bit much for him, as he's massively into vaporwave at the moment. Coming soon after your final advert break of this evening, we will be checking in with those common old people over on Clewsbury Common. Clewsbury Common episode 2, my micro soap radio drama, continues here on Durham On Air. Don't go anywhere. It's time for some world of music. I'm sure you'll agree. Back to Chris Pollard Live. We're approaching the end of the programme. Can you believe it? I can't actually. It happens every week. But I do hope that you have enjoyed this slightly shorter than usual programme after I forgot to press go on air at 11. At 9. I did forget to press it at 11 because that has not yet happened. But technical difficulties aside, it's been a very, very fun one, and I hope that you're sticking around for the Punk Corner with Fox straight after this programme. But what I would like to do now is, I started this last week, and I'll give you the sort of premise to it one more time, for those who weren't here. I was talking about the instancy of media right now and how the things that we consume are so bite-sized, and meme compilations, TikTok, all that sort of stuff, Instagram, Snapchat, teletext, it's all very quick and instant. So I'm trying to revive the radio drama, a very boring, drawn-out sort of thing, for this new TikTok generation. So I present to you episode 2 of my micro soap. Ladies and gentlemen, let's visit the people over on Clewsbury Common. Clewsbury Common.
Ernie, Bernie, pass me that spanner, will you, son?
Clewsbury Common was recorded on location within the bowels of the International Cornflake Conspiracy. The part of the spanner was played by Ralph Wiggum off The Simpsons. Well, it's been a wonderful show, guys. I really have enjoyed it. From the start where I didn't press connect to 27 minutes in when I realised, to right now where I'm going on about it for the 20 millionth time. But make sure you're sticking around, because in less than 10 minutes time the Punk Corner is officially underway with your host Fox. Man, it's going to be crazy. And I'm going to be back tomorrow here at 7 p.m. and also live on Durham On Air's Mixcloud page in a video form for Guppy Dancefloor Halloween special. Yes, if you want to watch me DJ live, make mistakes live, and go redder than the red face paint I've got on. If you're wondering why I'm going with red face paint on, it's because I'm going as... I couldn't think of anything in time. It doesn't matter anyway, because I'll be here at 7 p.m, make sure you are. But until then, you take care. Thanks for listening, and I'll see you next time on Durham On Air. Durham On Air!